Welcome to One Chemistry. This is 1 minute chemistry series. We are going to quickly see what is anti-Cram's rule. You will see basics and tricks. What is anti-Cram's rule? As the name suggests, it is the opposite of Cram's rule. Basically, you are predicting the diastereoselective addition. You are converting aldehyde into alcohol, but where the methyl group attacks here. You are using Regnard reagent. Methyl group can attack above or below. In anti-Cram's rule, the metal lock the conformation by chelating. That's what the insert is showing here. Since the chelation is there, it is also called as Cram's chelate model. Here we have to see some facts about Cram's model. Here Z group is the chelating group. It can be OH, OR or OME or phosphine oxides, amines or thiols. The chelating groups can be magnesium, zinc, copper, cerium, magnesium, manganese and lithium. The important fact you have to know here is exclusion in the chelating group, which is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Similarly, the chelating agent sodium plus and K plus, it won't chelate. It form normal Cram's rule, not anti-Cram's rule. What is the rule here? Here it is really about the trick. Here Z group, which is a chelating group, whether it is syn to heton or anti to heton. If it is syn to heton, the R minus group or incoming group attack the small side. If it is in anti position, the attack will be on medium side. The trick will be easy to remember. Syn means small side attack. S for S. Here I given some example to practice yourself. Two examples I given. In first example, chelating group is amine, which is syn to heton. So final product should be on small side. Similarly, the second example, OH and heton are syn to each other. The H minus will attack on the small side. That's all from this episode. Thanks for watching.